Good afternoon, friends. It's an absolute honor to be speaking with all of you. So just so that who all doesn't know what BARC India does, right? So we are into audience measurement for television right now in India. We are a joint industry body, but the difference is that we operate the currency as well. We don't like outsource like many other countries does or various other countries does from a joint industry standpoint to a Kantar or a Nielsen or a GFK. We have actually built the entire system on our own. So we run the largest audience measurement from a panel standpoint, right? So we have about 180,000 individuals that we measure. And I will take you through today in as how we have done by using these insights and using this data to unlock more and more value for content creators and advertisers as far as India is concerned. So, and how we have used innovation, because roughly 20% of our 500 people workforce is in technology, roughly 70% of our spends are out of technology. So we use technology very heavily. So, and let me take you through this. So this is a very famous word that we use very often in India called Jugaad. So it was added to Oxford Dictionary in 2017. What it really means is a flexible approach to problem solving using limited resources. So let me give you an example of innovation, how it happens, right? So look at this video. So this guy is running an optical shop. So he measures the power right there, and he offers the glass. And it's a very innovative thing, right? No resources, no capex. It's pure innovation. Look at other pieces that happens, right? So a DG set converted into a something which can use for traveling stuff. So a cycle converted into different things. So that's what we do even at BARC India. I think innovation is at core to whatever we do. What's unique? We all know size, diversity, media habits are very unique about India. It's almost like measuring Europe for us, right? The languages that we deal with, it's almost like measuring the entire Europe as far as India is concerned. And what's other unique thing about it is all three mediums, right? So be it TV, be it print, be it digital. Digital is the fastest growing segment that we have, but all of it is growing. Even print continues to grow in India. Every medium continues to grow in India, and TV is the largest medium. Right now, about $11 billion which contributes from a TV standpoint. Right now, about $4.5 billion is print, and roughly $3.2 billion as we speak is digital. So in India, television is big, right? So in terms of just the sheer size of it, look at the numbers. Just a hug and wink of Rahul Gandhi and Mr. Modi generated 14 million views. As far as just that 1 minute of hug and wink was concerned, as far as that viewership, TV viewership was there. This is about the size. We are talking about 173 million daily newspaper readers, 250 million of active social media users, and roughly 600 million of daily TV tune-ins. Still, 93% of the total video consumption, which includes YouTube, Amazon, Netflix, all the OTT world, if you combine, still happens to be on TV every week. So that's the size that we are talking about. We are talking about 836 million of TV viewers, so which is still about 67% penetration. So still India has good roughly 100 million households which are yet to own a television. So there is a large, long way to go as far as this piece is concerned. 925 billion man minutes, roughly 3 hours being spent on a daily basis. And how we deliver that is the 180,000 panel size, with sheer adx being $3.7 billion, the television adx. So what are we doing from an audience segmentation since 2015? We launched the service about 3.5 years back. So what we continue to do as far as and how we have unlocked the value. This is rural India. We have actually accounted for the unexplored rural India viewership. Rural India continued to measure see television, but it was not measured, right? So we have also, and I'll take you through examples of each and what we have done, how we have provided more insights to the ecosystem by delivering tools to them from a content standpoint or advertiser standpoint. There is another medium which we have opened up is out-of-home measurement. So we now measure television and out-of-home TV viewing as well, which is in the social eateries and everywhere else, and how we've used technology and innovation to drive all of that. So let me give you an example of what we have done from a rural consumer standpoint. So this used to be, the rural consumer used to consume about 307 billion minutes of TV every week, which has risen by 57% in 3 years. So that's the kind of consumption growth that we have seen as far as the rural consumer is concerned. And what it has led to is the CPG guys like Unilever and Nestle grew their spends by about 49% and 100% as far as rural India is concerned. This segment, it was not that people were not consuming television, it just by measuring them and just by about delivering to the advertisers that this is what they are consuming, I think that's where it evoked the spends. The number of advertisers, 130 when we started with, who were spending in this segment, became 247 in 2018. So that's a 90% growth as far as this segment was concerned. Rural is a very powerful segment. It accounts for roughly 40% of the entire FMCG market, which is CPG market, and it continues to grow. It'll continue to grow at a CAGR of 15% till 2025, and the majors, all the global majors and the local CPG majors continue to be bullish about that. So I think this was a very important segment for us to unleash, and this could have only happened because of the cost that we could deliver it, right? So, so otherwise it was not possible to do this. Another piece that we sort of do is just the sheer size of the panel, 180,000, the sheer size helps us to give much more data to the ecosystem. We actually report data for each market. So we report roughly 17 markets, 4 different town classes within that, 2 genders, 5 SEC socioeconomic profiles, and 9 age cuts. So it's 17 into 4 into 2 into 5 into 9. So that's the kind of data cuts that we provide to the ecosystem to plan and execute their data spends. And all of this has been possible just because we have been able to use technology by using a meter which is roughly 1/12 of the global meter cost. So it's an indigenous meter, we developed it in India, and that's why we could scale the panel so significantly. And this has also helped us to give insights to the content guys. So we deliver a product called Bio News, right? So for all the news guys in there, you can actually know what are the top news stories, what has worked for them, which personality has actually worked for them, what has led to the growth of the news viewership. Is it content? Is it less commercial duration? Which personality? So all of that. It has helped them to curate better content, see minute by minute where the viewership uplift has happened compared to what was playing, compared to competition, what competition used to play at that time. As I said, which personality has actually worked for them. So we have used a lot of data and insights here to give them personality-wise viewership as what has really, and this is all through video analytics. We have used a lot of video analytics to come in play to give all this data to the news guys. And a similar change we are bringing in the sports, for the sports content guys and even for the general entertainment channel guys. So all of this we are now introducing for other segments of content as well. So let's look into the future, how we are unlocking value to the advertisers. As I said, out of home, which was again an unexplored viewing which was happening. So we have actually started measuring that as well. So roughly 1,058 restaurants covered, 1,500 meters installed, roughly 120 towns that we actually measure out of home TV in. And we are providing this consolidated TV plus out of home report in the market. So it's really what we provide right now is TV viewership at home and TV viewership at eateries, so which gives a combined viewership. And look at the lift that has happened. So we saw Indian Premier League, which is the biggest cricketing tournament. It's almost like FIFA as far as India is concerned. So it happens every year. We saw 8% lift from the out-of-home viewership. And FIFA soccer saw 41% lift for the out-of-home viewer segment. So it's a sizable audience that was sitting there, which is yet to be monetized. So I think that's what the power of that was. Another piece that we did was the split beam measurement, how geo-targeting played a role and how people are actually, advertisers are actually looking at this to monetize, and how they are actually looking to target their audiences more specifically rather than broadcasting. So we started the geo-targeting measurement as well. And what it led to, you could see as we once the advertisers actually started getting the measurement as well, and hence the confidence in the medium increased further, we have seen doubled inquiries as far as and retail sales increased by 35% for the advertising ecosystem. So I think that's what it led to, believing in the medium once you start giving the data out. But we don't stop at this. I think panel is an important source for us, but we believe that we have to travel a journey and how we can increase the panel and move towards this. There is a big debate of panel versus census as far as television measurement is also concerned, and hence we are working with all the distribution partners there, all the TV operators there, television distribution operators, to see how we can actually expand the panel size. So right now we have partnerships in place for about 45 million homes. We are still in testing phase. Hopefully next year we'll be able to demonstrate as what we have done there. But this is a journey that we are traveling, and we are working with other partners as well to augment the data, how we can actually make it closer to more behavioral, and how we can actually make it closer to what we say, you can know the consumer better. Though we provide a lot of granularity, but I think there is a need for more. So I think that's what the journey we are traveling towards. Again, just to sort of expand on this, the other piece that we are working on is the traditional TV versus OTT, right? So India, 93% of TV total video still happens on TV, on television, despite only 66% television penetration. And in that 66%, the unique fact is 80% of that is CRT TV sets. So, you see a huge cycle of growth opportunity within the television ecosystem. These CRTs will convert to LEDs, LCDs. You will see a lot of content exploration happening there, a lot of HD consumption going, a lot of, as we have seen that more and more channels become available, the consumption goes up. So all of this, as we keep on expanding, the important aspect is to capture the OTT digital viewing as well. That's the journey that we are also traveling right now. Digital viewership measurement is another piece that we are working towards. And this is what we are doing, right? So in terms of the ecosystem is concerned, 47% local languages, less than 3% house with Wi-Fi. So there are challenges infrastructurally as far as India is concerned right now, but it's growing, it's leapfrogging. We have seen how there is a telecom player called Reliance Jio who has come in, who has exploded the market from a telecom consumption standpoint, and we would see that only gaining speed. Right now, we are dealing with the lowest data cost in the world as far as India is concerned. So we are seeing enormous amount of consumption happening in this space, and which will only set to grow. And we want to be where the consumer is. And hence, we are traveling this journey as well with the ecosystem to actually give them a unified matrix, a meaningful matrix, and verification of audiences. So which will also lead to growth, to further enhancement of growth in this digital space as well. That's it from my side. Thank you.